A very good morning, students. We are in our regular class lecture and this is your petrology practical. In our previous class, we had just allotted the mineral percentage, right, in CIPW classification. And in this class, we will try to name the rock according to the CIPW classification. So, after following those rules, you might have filled a form like this, right? And the values have been filled right here. That is, you might have filled up to the molecular portion. So in this class, you will try to complete the form, that is the table, and you will also name the rock according to the CIPW classification. So you, after filling this, that is, you might have filled up to the molecular proportion, right? So we have to convert the molecular proportion into percentage. So in our first step in the CIPW classification, we have converted the percentage into molecular proportion, right? That is for an individual element. In this step, what we will do is we will just reverse that. We will convert the molecular proportion of the mineral into the percentage of that mineral in this rock, right? For that, what we will do is we have to multiply the molecular proportion into molecular weight, then divide it by 1000. Just reversing the first step of the first video, right? So after doing that, we will get the answer like this. So just to cross check your answer, if the total is somewhere near 100, then your answer is quite right. If it is far from 100, then there may be some doubt in your calculation steps, right? That we can cross check. And after doing that, what we will do is, you can see there are some set brackets. So we have to add those numbers in that set bracket. For example, for Q, you might be having only one number. And for F, you can see there are three numbers. So you have to add the three. Likewise, you have to fill the whole form. And after doing that, you can see there are set brackets also, which is grouping into two. The first one is Salic group, and you have to add those four things together. And the Femic group, you have to add the four things together, right? So you can add Q by plus F plus L plus C. The answer is 93.93, and for this thing, you don't have L and C. And the Femic group, you have to add P plus O plus M plus A. And for O, there is nothing in this table, right? And after doing this, you should remember one thing, that is, all the subdivisions, there are a few range of numbers that we had discussed in the previous video also, right? The first division, if the answer is more than 7, then the answer will be in the division number 1. And if the answer range is in 7 to 1.667, then the answer is in division 2. And if it is in 1.667 to 0.6, then it will be in division 3. And if it is in the range of say 0.6 to 0.143, then it is in the division 4. And if it is less than 0.143, then it is in division number 5. Is that clear? So remember this number. This will be continuing in the whole sum, right, after this. So it has been classified into 4, that is the class, then order, then range, then subrange, that we will see one by one. And at the end of the video, we will also try to have an example so that it will be easy for you to do it by yourself, right? So the first, that is the class classification, is based on the Salic biofemic ratio, and this you can get from the table last line, right? And according to the answer, it has been classified into 5, that is first one. You remember the numbers, right? If the first one, that the answer is more than 7, that will be in the first class, that is per salic, that shows the predominant of salic minerals. And if the answer is in the range of say 7 to 1.667, then it is in class 2, that is called do salic, that is dominance of salic elements. If the answer is in the range of say 1.667 to 0.6, then it is in the class 3, that is salfemic. That is, salic minerals is somewhat equal to the femic minerals. And the fourth one is, say, if the answer is 0.6 to 0.143, then it shows the dominant of femic minerals. And if it is, say, less than 0.143, then it shows the predominance of femic minerals, right? And remember, this class has been further subdivided into order. The first three has been grouped, and the second two is in other group, right? So we will see the first three for the first one. Then the first three has been further subdivided into orders, that is based on the Q by F or F by L ratio, because the Q and L, that is the quartz and feldspath oil, will not come together, right? So there will be Q by F or F by L ratio. Okay. So if you are doing say Q by F, we will see if the answer is more than 7, that will be per quaric, that is predominant of quartz. then this, if it is in the range of say 7 to 1.667, then it is feldo-quaric, that is the order is in the range, order is in 2. If the answer is say 1.667 to 0.6, that then it is quartzphelic, that is quartz and feldspar is somewhat equal. And if the answer is say in the range of 0.6 to 0.143, then the feldspar is dominant over quartz. And if you are doing Q by F and the answer is say less than 0.143, then the order is perphelic, that is the predominant of feldspar minerals. And from this, this is the transition zone. If it crosses this line, then it will be the feldspathoid minerals. If it is before this point, then it is quartz minerals, right? So if you are doing say F by L, that is feldspar by feldspathoid, okay, and if the answer is say less than 0.143, you are in the order number 9, that is perlenic. If it is say in the range of 0.6 to 0.143, you are in order number 8, that is feldolenic. And if the answer is say 1.667 to 0.6, it is say order number 7, that is lenphilic, that is both are equal. And if the answer is say 7 to 1.667, then it is called the lendophenic, that is in the order number 6. And if you are doing F by L, and if the answer is more than 7, then it is perphelic, okay. So the perphelic will be there when you are doing Q by F and the answer is less than 0.143, then it is also perphelic. And if you are doing say F by L and if the answer is more than 7, then also it is called perphelic. Okay, so this is the transition zone. If you are in this side, if the answer is less than 0.143, then also it is in the order number 5. And if you are doing in this side, that is F by L, and if the answer is more than 7, then also the order is number 5. Okay, just keep that in mind. And don't forget these terms, because you have to mention this, you have to remember, you have to answer right in the answer, right? And this order has been further subdivided into 5 ranges, that is based on alkali by calcic ratio. So the first range, that is the predominance of alkali, that is termed as peralkalic. And the second one is dome alkalic, that is dominance of alkalic. The third one is alkali calcic, that is both are somewhat equal. The fourth one is docalcic and the fifth one is percalcic. And these 5 ranges have been subdivided into sub ranges. The first 3 have 5 divisions of sub range, then the fourth one of the range have 3 divisions of sub range, and the fifth one have no any sub ranges. So on the basis of K2O by Na2O ratio, the first 3 ranges has been subdivided into 5 sub ranges. The first one is per potassic, then the second one is do potassic, then the third one is sodi potassic, then the fourth one is do sodic, and the fifth one is persodic. So these are the 5 classifications of first 3 ranges, okay. The fourth range has been further subdivided into 3 sub ranges. The first 2 together called as pre-potassic. Remember, the term PRE denotes there are 3 subdivisions. If it starts with say PER, then they have 5 subdivisions. You can see wherever you can see it is PER, there are 5 divisions. It is PER, there are 5 divisions. It is PER, there are also 5 divisions. Likewise, it is coming here. But if it is termed as PRE, then there is only 3 divisions. So if the answer is, that is if you are dividing K2O by Na2O, and if the answer is more than 1.667, that is sufficient, that will be in pre-potassic. And if it is in the range of 1.667 to 0.6, then it is sodi-potassic. If it is less than 0.6, then it will come under persodic. That is what they have mentioned, 4 and 5. This is 4 and 5, right? And this is 1 and 2. This 2, that is if the answer range is more than 1.667, that will be pre-potassic. If the answer range is less than 0.6, then it will be pre-sodic. For the fifth range, there is no any sub-range. Just remember that. Is that clear? So the first 3 classes has been subdivided into 9 orders, and these 9 orders have been classified into 5 ranges. And for the first 3 ranges, there are 5 sub-ranges. And for the fourth range, there are three sub-ranges. And for the fifth range, there is no any sub-range. Is that clear for this portion? So we'll go for the next one, that is the class 4 and class 5. That is in the next page. The class 4 and class 5, you know that the range of salic biofemic ratio is 0.6 to 0.143 and less than 0.143. And this has been further divided into orders, that is on the basis of P plus O by M. And this value you can get from the table, right? So this class has been divided into five orders, that is the perpolic, that is predominant of folic minerals, followed by dopolic, then polymitic, then domitic, then permitic. Remember, whatever you are seeing in the first three classes, that answer will not cross that line and come here, right? If you are in first three classes, there is no need of doing this portion. And if you are in the 4 and 5 classes, you have to only follow this sheet and there is no need of seeing the previous one, right? So this order, that is first 3, for this class 4 and 5, there is one more extra thing, that is called the section division. In the class 1, 2, 3, there is no any subdivision of order as section. But in this class 4 and 5, there is a subdivision of this order as section, okay? So the first three orders have been subdivided into sections as 5 sections, that is perpyric, then dopyric, then pyrolic, then domolic, then perolic. So these are the 5 divisions of, 5 division of sections of the order, 1, 2, 3. And for the fourth order, there are actually 3 sections. The first 1 and 2 together called as prepyric. Remember the term PRE, there are 3 divisions, right? Then the third one is pyrolic, then the fourth one is preolic for the order number 4. And for order number 5, there is no any subdivision of section. Is that clear? So this is an extra portion in the class 4 and 5, that is section division. Then there are ranges. The range classification is based on MgO plus FeO plus Na2O by CaO ratio. If you add all the that is MgO plus FeO plus Na2O, then divide it by CaO, if you are getting an answer that is more than 7, then that belongs to range number 1, that is permeric. And if it is say between 7 to 0.667, that it is in range 2, that is domeric. If it is in the third range, that is called calcimeric, then followed by docalcic, then percalcic, right? So these are the 5 ranges, and the same way the 5 ranges has been subdivided into 3 subranges. The first 3 range has been subdivided into 5 subranges based on MgO by FeO plus Na2O ratio. If you are in say having more than 7, then it is in the first subrange, that is permagnesic, followed by domagnesic, or the third one is the magnesiferous, or the fourth one is doferous, and the fifth one is perferous. Okay, so these are the 5 subranges of the first 3 ranges. And if you are in the fourth range, that is docalcic, it has been further subdivided into 3. The first 2 together called as premagnesic, then the third one is magnesiferous, and the 4 and 5 is perferous. Remember, it is here actually 4 and 5. Okay, I have not changed it, actually I have just mentioned it as 4 and 5. And for the fifth range, there is no any subrange. Is that clear? Let me repeat it once again. If the value of salic biofemic ratio is less than 0.6 to 0.143, it will be in the class 4. If it is less than 0.143, then it will be class 5. And these two classes together subdivided into 5 orders. And these are the 5 orders, that is based on P plus O by M ratio. And for class 4 and 5, there is subdivision called section, which is not there in class 1, 2, 3. And this section division is based on P by O ratio. Okay. So for the first 3 orders, there are 5 sections. And for the 4th order, there is 3 sections. And for 5th order, there is no any subdivision as section. And after doing this, this 5 orders has been further subdivided into 5 ranges based on MgO plus FeO plus Na2O by CaO ratio. And this 5 ranges, the first 3 range has been subdivided into 5 sub ranges. The fourth range is further subdivided into three ranges, and for the fifth one there is no any subdivision of sub range. Is that clear? Okay, as mentioned here earlier, we will do an example which is we saw in the first trip. Remember these numbers, for that I have kept it here. So the first is the class, that is by Salic biofemic ratio, that you can see the Salic value is 93.93 and the Femic ratio is 5.83. So we have to divide this two, and what we will get is 16.11, which is actually more than 7. So this belongs to the class, that is first one you remember, per Salic. Okay, this is how you have to do one after other. So this is the class division. Then the second one is the order division, which is based on Q by F. You can see the Q value, which is here, that is 35.37, followed by F, that is 58.56. And if I divide this thing, what you will get is 0.604, which is in the range of this one, right? That is in the division number 3. So this belongs to the order, that is quadriphyllic, that is in 3, right? The third one is range, that is alkali by calcic. So the alkali is these two, that is 32 plus 24.4, which is 56.4. By calcic, which is just 2.16, if you divide, what we will get is 26.1. So that actually more than 7. So that belongs to range 1, that is per alkalic. And the fourth division is the sub range, which is K2O by Na2O. So here it is the K2O, that is 24.4, and the Na2O is actually 32. So if you divide this two, what you will get is 0.76. So which is in this range, that is 1.667 to 0.6. So that belongs to the sub range 3, that is sodi potassic. Is that clear? So after doing this, you have to mention the result, that is according to the CIPW classification, the rock has been classified into I311, that is Roman letter 1311. Remember, whenever you are writing the class, that has to be mentioned in Roman letter. And if you are writing the order, that can be mentioned as numbers, then range also number, then sub range also number. So just try it yourself. If you have still any doubt, you can just ask me. Okay. Thank you.